Hi Facebook friends, Stamper friends. Today I'm going to try get my hand at another video. I'm doing it a little different. I'm recording it on a different device and then I'm going to upload it. So we'll see how this works. If you're seeing it, it must have worked okay. So I think today we're going to work on a more masculine birthday card. I find it hard sometimes to find a good masculine card, and this one is I think a good option. This particular one opens to the top like this, but the one we're going to do opens the traditional way. So let's get started on our card. The first thing you're going to do is cut your base out of crumb cake cardstock. Sometimes when I say that, people don't know what that means. This is simply an 8.5 by 11 piece of cardstock that I've cut in half along the long axis, and then we'll fold it in half to make our card base. I don't have my bone folder with me, so I'm going to have to improvise here a little bit with my scissors to get a nice crisp fold. Okay. Now, if I had wanted the card to open up this way, like this one does, I would simply cut it in the middle this way, this direction. But since I wanted it to open the other way, that's the way I cut it, the more traditional way. So what we'll do is we will start with the stamping. I love this stamp. It's a single stamp that Stampin' Up! Sells called Happy Birthday. You can see it's been well loved. I like it because it's simple, sweet, not a lot of fussing with it. So I'm going to use my Early Espresso ink, and if you've never opened our ink pads, that's how they open. And I have a square of Whisper White. I'm sorry, this is not Whisper White. This is very vanilla, and it's 2¾ by 2¾. Actually, before I stamp, I think I'm going to go through the sizes for all of our pieces of our card. Let me pull that in for you to see. So we talked about the base. Then we have the first layer, which is Early Espresso, and that's 4 by 5¼. Then I have a cut of our Designer Series paper. I have a piece of that that I have cut to 3¾ by 5 inches. This piece of Early Espresso is 3 by 3, and this piece of Very Vanilla is 2¾ by 2¾. So pretty simple cutting. I just love this Designer Series paper that we have in our annual catalog. It's all wood tones. Let me show you. It's in a 6x6 pack, and let me show you some of the designs. I'm going to use this one today. There's a darker wood. Here's one that looks like the rings of the tree. This one's a lighter color. Got some different ones there. That's really dark. A little lighter. You can see so many possibilities. One thing that's great to use this paper for is there is a framelit that will cut out a little basket or a little crate. Let me see if I can find it. I have one here somewhere. Let me see. Hang on. I'll get it. Here it is. We've used this. Actually, this we used we used paper and embossed it with the wood tone. But see this little crate? Isn't that cute and clever? You could put a treat in it. But it'd be perfect for using with this wood grain look paper. Okay, so back to our card. Okay, we have our piece of very vanilla, which like I said was 2¾ by 2¾. I'm just going to take the birthday stamp, ink it up on our early espresso ink, and put it right down on the square. Just hold it for a second, and there we go. And I'm not too so happy with it. I mean, it's a little light here. It's not bad, but I'm going to see if I can do it better. I'm going to flip it over. That's the great thing about paper. Most of it has two sides. So if you're not exactly got it right the first time, you've got a second chance. Okay, so let me see. I got it centered. There we go. Make sure I press it down real good. Let it set. And there we go. Much better. Much better. I'm much happier with that. So that's our happy birthday sentiment. I'm going to use the snail adhesive. And adhere it to this. Right here. While we're gluing, we're going to glue this on. A tip I want to tell you about that you could do to save yourself some paper is to, if you're doing a big base like this, mat, that you're going to cover up with something else, I could have used my framelits in my Big Shot to cut the square right out of this big piece. If you don't have a Big Shot and framelits, that might be a little more difficult. But saves you a little bit of paper. But I just cut mine on the on my cutting board. Okay, let's put this on here like this. Beautiful, beautiful. Now, here's our sample, our original. And you can see there's some linen thread around it. So I'm gonna use some dimensionals so this pops up just a little bit. I'm gonna put those on first. Okay, and that's what I'll use to adhere it onto there. But before I do that, I have a length of, I believe this was 30 inches. Let me look at my note. Yep, this was 30 inches of our linen thread. You can see I've used a lot of it. It's inexpensive, but it's a lot of bang for the buck. So I'm going to wrap this around 2-3 times. Nothing fancy. Here, I'm just going to tie a knot. Here. I can, this is easy, you can slide it into place however you want it to look. There really is no right or wrong. Let's move it around till I like it, and I'm going to clip off the ends. There we go. Now I'm going to take off the covering on the dimensionals. You know, this is a little loose, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of adhesive right there to just tack those down on there so they don't move around so much. So you see these dimensionals, they're a little foam adhesive pieces, and they have a little piece of paper on them. Sometimes they can be a booger to get off, but here's a little trick. Take your fingernail and pop it up like that, and they usually pops right off. So let's do that. It made a liar out of me. Of course, it would help if I had some fingernails. Okay, so now it's ready to attach to my card. I'm going to put it right here. And there you go. Got yourself a nice masculine birthday card that didn't take any time at all. So please visit my blog at denisewill.blogspot.com, You can visit my Stampin' Up! Store. There'll be links that you can follow. And find my business page on Facebook. It's Stamping with Denise Will. Love to see you there, and I'd like to get your comments on the card. Thanks. Have a great day.